So thank you for introduction. So I'm Masaaki Imaizumi from the Institute of Statistical Mathematics in Japan. So firstly, I thank the organizers to give me a good opportunity to give my talk in this workshop. So this is in this talk is mainly theoretical side of the deep learning. So we investigate the why deep learning works well by from the aspects of theory. So this is a joint work with Kendo Fukumizu from the same institute. So this is an overview of my study. So everything in my study is in this slide. So question is very simple. Why deep neural networks perform better than other methods? So other means the kernel methods, so Fourier methods and others. So we basically simple question. And we take this approach, theoretical analysis for the generalization errors with a non-smooth data generating process. So, and then finally we will claim that these are results. So when the data are generated by the non-smooth functions, so DNN theoretically outperform others. So in detail, so DNN are, optimal in some sense for estimating the functions, and others are not optimal. So the DNN theoretically outperform other methods. So this is our overview of our study. So first, we provide some introduction about deep learning. So maybe all of you may know the history of the deep learning. So this is a very brief introduction about the deep learning. So in the 20th century, idea of the neural networks developed, but there's some technical difficulties, so it is not for use well. But in this century, the difficulty was solved by, development of the computers or the appearance of big data. So, and then in the 2020, in this year, some breakthrough appears, after some competition, that deep learning provides the high performance than others. So the many researchers focus on the performance of the deep learning, and it is used in many applications, kind of, so for example, AlphaGo, or self-driving car, or many other applications. So everyone may agree about the high performance of the deep learning, like deep neural networks. But the question is very simple. So why it performs better than others? And many theoretical researchers try to provide or explain the advantage of the deep neural networks theoretically. So from the many aspects of the from the many theoretical sides. So this is just a part of the studies. Optimization theory or approximation theory or statistical learning theory or information theory. So many theories try to explain the performance of the deep neural networks. But understanding is still a developing problem in our understanding. So, so in the study, we applied the statistical theory to clarify the mechanism of the performance of the deep neural networks. So this is our, research question. So, and then in the study, we considered generalization error of the regression problem. So generalization error is standard to measure the performance of the estimator. So this is expectation of the squared distance between the true function and estimator. So we use this norm to explain, some notation for this generalization error. And we also consider the regression problem. So F star is the true function, is F star, which is the d-dimensional input, and output is a scalar. And we consider this regression model. It's very simple. So y is the output variable, and x is the input variable, and epsilon is the Gaussian noise. And so this is, and we assume that this x and y is generated from this regression model with unknown f star. And suppose that we have the n observations, so this set of the, pairs of the x and y. So suppose that we have these data sets. And by using the data sets, we want to estimate the F star, which is unknown. So by some way, we will construct some estimator F hat and measure that this generalization error in these settings. Of course, we can see that the small generalization error assures that the good performance of algorithm. So this is some regression problem. So mainly the classification problem is mainly also common in application, which means why is the discrete random variable. So But I mean, so this is regression, it's a different problem. But this framework can, I mean, also apply to the classification problem. But in this study, we focus on the distribution problem mainly. So we want to, I mean, investigate the volume, I mean, size of the, this error of by the deep neural networks. Of course, this problem is very, I mean, well investigated in the many fields. So this is, I mean, existing result by the statistical, I mean, classical statistical theory. So, for example, by this paper. So this is a brief, I mean, introduction of the result, existing results. So when f star, which is another function, it's, I mean, smooth, it means the differentiable, it means. So f star is smooth, so not only deep neural networks, but also many, many popular methods. I mean, kernel methods, or I mean, orthogonal series methods, or not deep methods, I mean, shallow neural networks, shallow methods, achieve optimality. So this is, I mean, classical result from the statistical, I mean, mathematical statistical result theory. So as you know, so I mean, so this is an example of the, I mean, other methods. I mean, kernel methods is, I mean, they construct the estimator by the linear sum of the kernel functions. And also machine methods is a kind of, I mean, more general methods. I mean, so f star is, I mean, constructed by the sum of the basis functions. For example, the Fourier basis functions or spline basis functions. So this is a classical result. And so this is a detailed version. So we provide a more, I mean, detailed description about the result. So if f star is a beta time differentiable, so beta is a 1 or 2 or 3, so which the differentiable, so many popular methods provide an estimator, if hard. So many methods can provide the estimator such that the generalization error is bounded by, I mean, this term. I mean up to a constant. So this volume is bounded by the this value. I mean, so small n is a number of observations. So as n increases, the error converges to zero. So as n is goes to infinity, so this generalization error converges to zero. And the speed of convergence is characterized by, I mean, this value, I mean, minus 2 beta over 2 beta plus large d. So, and it is also shown, theoretically shown, that this rate, I mean, this value, is an optimal rate in the minimax sense. So it means that, I mean, it's kind of the, there's not many variation about the definition of the optimality, but in the minimax sense, so this is the optimal rate. So as long as f star is smooth, so many methods can achieve the optimality. So we consider that when f star is smooth, so deep neural networks cannot outperform others theoretically, just theoretically, not practically, but theoretically. So we know that the deep neural networks can be optimal, but the kernel methods is also optimal. So I mean, deep neural networks and others are equivalent in this sense. So I mean, as long as we assume that the f-star is smooth, we cannot explain the performance of deep neural networks. This is our, I mean, starting point. So to provide the, I mean, theory which can explain the performance of the deep networks, we focus on the non-smooth functions. So this is just a brief overview, I mean, idea of the non-smooth functions. So assume that let this large square is, I mean, set of the all functions, discontinuous also, okay. So I mean L2 integrable functions. And the small square shows the, I mean, set of the smooth function, I mean, differentiable functions. So, and then this, I mean, small set is a target of, I mean, existing theory. So every theory, this investigate, I mean, investigate, consider about this small set. But, I mean, so, and then we consider the more, I mean, a little bit general set of the functions, including non-smooth functions. So as long as the function belongs to the small square, we cannot describe the advantage of the deep neural networks. So we focus on the more large set of functions. So our, I mean, idea or hypothesis is like that. So when f star is non-smooth, so deep neural networks can, we are not sure, but we try to show the advantage of the deep neural networks with non-smooth, I mean, true functions. So to provide the theory, we focused on the this non-smooth functions. I mean, piecewise smooth function is a notion of non-smooth functions we focus on. So firstly, we described, I mean, we provide explanation of the piecewise functions. So we assume that a support of these functions is divided into several pieces. And within each of the pieces, so functions are sufficiently smooth. But on the boundary of the pieces, functions are non-smooth. I mean, even discontinuous, okay. So this is, I mean, brief, I mean, simple example of, I mean, piecewise smooth functions. So this is a plot of the functions with a two-dimensional input, and output is a scalar. So this is a plot in the three-dimensional space. And we consider that this, I mean, the two-dimensional plane is a support of the function, of this function. And we can see that the support is divided into three pieces. I mean, this piece, and this piece, and this piece. And you can see that in each of the pieces, the functions are sufficiently smooth, but in the boundary of the pieces, functions are discontinuous. So this is a very, I mean, brief introduction, example of the piecewise smooth functions. So, and we provide a brief version of the characterization, mathematical formation of the piecewise smooth functions. So let large M is a number of pieces in this support. And let Fm, M is an index, and let Fm is a, I mean, sufficiently smooth functions. We consider the Hilbert space. So which is the beta smooth function. I mean, beta times differentiable functions. So I mean, H to beta is a denotes a set of the smooth functions, and Fm belongs to this function set. And Rm is the set in this support. I mean, piece, Rm denotes a piece for each M. So we consider that this piece has the alpha smooth boundaries. I mean, so boundary of the piece, pieces are alpha times differentiable. And we consider that some kink points, I mean, some, we allow that this piece to have some J kink points. So J is an integer and kink points. And using the notation, we define the set of the piecewise smooth function by this form. So you can see that the Fn is a smooth function, and 1Rm is an indicator function on this set, I mean this piece. So it is, so this is a function which is 1 when x is in this piece, and otherwise it is 0. So we can see that the Fm times 1Rm only denotes that the which can describe the realization, describe that the Fm is a smooth function, only realizes x is in the this piece. And we describe that this piece by smooth function by a linear sum of the this, I mean, sets, and we show that the large M is a number of the pieces. So you can, we plot the example. So this is a brief example of the piece by smooth functions. So and here, this this shape denotes a first piece in this domain. So we can see that this piece corresponds to this piece, and you can see that this low-level smooth function only realizes in on this piece, and you can see that high-level smooth functions realizes only when the x is in the pieces. So by combination of the smooth function and notion of the piece R, so we can describe that this piece by smooth functions. So by using that this formation of the piece by smooth function, we will derive the convergence rate of the degeneration error by deep neural networks. So we want to estimate the function in this set. And we will provide the estimators. So firstly, we provide models by deep neural networks. So this is very, very common. So all of you may know that this formation, but we provide a very, very brief notation. So large L is an upper layers, and D is an dimensions of the internal layers. And eta is an activation function. And in this study, we focus on the real activation function. And also, we consider transformation by in the L's layer. So this is very common. So X is an input. And we consider the affine transformation of the X by matrix parameter A and vector parameter B. And we consider the, we input the transformed X into the activation function, and output is the transformation layer. And we define the set of the modules by deep neural networks by composition at this form. So fractal FNN denotes a set of the function defined by the deep neural networks. These are very brief, I mean, very common notation. And by using this set of the models by deep neural networks, we define the very, very brief, I mean, very common estimators. The first one is the least square estimator, which is defined as empirical risk minimization by this. I mean, so F hat L is a least square estimator, which is a minimizer of the sum of the least squares, I mean, squared loss. So we define. So maybe all of you know that this is a non-convex problem, so it's very difficult to obtain the exact value of the F hat L, but this study is mainly focused on the theoretical statistical theory, so we assume that this minimizer is obtained. So of course we can use some many good optimization techniques to obtain or approximate this minimizer. And also everyone can criticize that this is really difficult to obtain this minimizer. So to avoid the criticism, we also consider the base estimator. So we consider the prior on the set of the models. We consider the some finite dimensional prior distribution on the parameters of the deep neural networks. So and pi denotes a prior distribution on the set of the models. And by using the models, and we can define the posterior like this in usual way. And finally, we can define the estimator, the base estimator, as the posterior mean. So F hat B denotes the base estimator by the deep neural networks. So by using this form, we can avoid the non-convex problem. Of course, I mean, calculating this posterior distribution is also, I mean, difficult. But in this study, we ignore the computation problem. Okay, so we define the, non-smooth function and estimator by using the model of the deep neural networks. And we go to the theoretical result. So firstly, we provide a brief, illustration of our proof. So this is a very, rough idea of the inequality by statistical theory to bound the generalization error. So generalization error is, roughly bounded by the approximation error and model complexity. So approximation is very simple. So how the model is close to the truth function. And the model complexity means that, it's close to the, ideal capacity or any other. So it describes the volume of hypothesis. Volume of the this FNN. So which is nearly equal to the, not just nearly, but nearly equal to the number of the parameters in this, set of the models. So what we want to do is find a good this set of the models to balance the approximation error and the model complexity. And here, if model has many parameters, so this sum decreases. However, the model complexity increases. So this has a trade-off. So what you want to do is find a good FN which decreases the approximation error by a small number of parameters. This is our ideal FNN. And to obtain the good FNN, so we apply the good approximation, good result from the approximation theory. And so by using these good, very good papers, we obtain the good approximator for the for many mathematical operations. So let G blah blah be a small deep neural networks with well activations. And by using this result, so we know that there exist good deep neural networks for effective approximations, summation, multiplication, and which can represent a smooth function, and also which can represent an indicator function on pieces. And to provide the generalization error, we construct this exact form of the deep neural networks. So G dot is our deep networks, which we explicitly constructed. And let the G dot is equal to here. Shallow layer, we construct a smooth function, indicator function pieces, and we multiply it by deep neural networks of multiplication, and finally we summing up by the deep neural networks of summation. And here, the model complexity of this G dot is by this form. So I mean the parameter for the smooth function times n plus parameter for the integral function times n plus some others. Others means that I mean parameter for the multiplication and summation. Of course, the approximation error is bounded by this term. So I mean the total approximation error is bounded by the sum of the approximation error for each elements of the piecewise function, I mean piecewise smooth functions. I mean smooth function and integral function and others. I mean multiplication and summation. Okay. So we can evaluate the two errors, I mean model complexity and approximation errors from the each of the terms, I mean each of the smooth function and the function separately. And using by inequalities, we can provide the bound for the generalization error. Okay, so provide the main, before the main result, we provide some conditions about the deep neural networks. This is a condition. So deep neural network satisfied condition D denotes this phenomenon. So deep neural networks satisfy the following conditions. So the number of parameters is equal to the this value with some constant. So this is just, this condition is some order, about the order. So this is unknown, but we can, we assume, we impose a condition that the number of parameters of the deep neural networks is like this. And the maximum value of the parameter is like this, and number of layer is like this. So this is the condition for the optimality. And this is our main result. So assume that the F star is a piecewise smooth function. And then there exists a deep neural network with condition D, which I imposed before, and such that the least square estimators satisfying this result. I mean, generalization error is bounded by this term, up to a constant and up to log factor. So you know, these two terms describe the speed of convergence of the generalization error. And we can see that this first term describes the speed of the convergence for estimating the smooth function. And this term is, describes the speed of the convergence for the indicator function on pieces. Oh, this is the convergence result about the risk estimator. And this is also result about the Bayes estimator. So the reads are completely same. So firstly, we can claim that both estimators provide the same convergence result. Okay, so we can we obtain the rate of convergence. This is our first result. Of course, we obtain the rate. So it is good or not, we don't know. So we provide some optimality result about the optimality of the convergence rate. So this statement is a little bit complex, but let F bar an arbitrary estimator, not only deep network, so any estimator is possible. And for any good estimator, convergence rate is bounded below by this term. So, and this statement describes that this rate is the minimax optimal rate. It is the optimal rate in the minimax sense. So, and we can see that this minimax rate is corresponds to, is equal to the convergence rate of the deep neural networks up to log factors. So we can stay to our first result is that the estimator by deep neural networks are optimal in the minimax sense for estimating the piecewise smooth functions. So this is our first main result. Okay, so we know that the optimality of the deep neural networks. So how about other methods? So it's a second concern of our study. And we provide some statistical results about the Kernel methods and Fourier methods. But because of time limitation, we provide the one of the strongest results in our paper. Okay, so this is the proposition about the other methods. So for any linear estimator, I mean linear estimator means the estimator with this form. I mean F hat is the sum of the this form. I mean which is a linear in yi. Linear in y is the definition of the linear estimator. So for any linear estimator, there exists a piecewise smooth function. And to estimate the F star, the linear estimators cannot obtain the optimal rate with, I mean, piecewise smooth functions. So this result is strongly depends on this corollary in 1993. So a little bit old, but we apply this corollary and we show that this result. So, and we can see that the linear estimator is a, I mean, the set of linear estimator is a very wide. Family of linear estimator contains the kernel methods and Fourier methods and shallow neural networks. So we can see that some of the common standard methods cannot be optimal when f star is a piecewise smooth functions. So this is our claim from the statistical results. So when true functions f star is non-smooth, piecewise smooth, so deep neural networks can achieve the minimax optimal rate. And in contrast, some of other methods, like kernels, cannot be optimal when true functions are non-smooth. This is our statistical result. And to provide this result, we also provide a characterization of the structure, architecture of the deep neural networks, like this. So layer should be this order, and non-zero parameter should be this order, and scale of the parameter should be increases as sample size increases. Okay, this is our statistical result. And we provide some explanation, but the time is also limited. So it's limited, so we can skip this here. And we do some simple experiments like this. And this is the true function, and we estimate this non-smooth structure by deep neural networks. And we did some comparison about the loss, but the deep networks performs better when true functions are non-smooth. Okay, and we provide a summary. Okay, so the goal of the study is to clarify the mechanism why deep neural networks outperform others. And we have a result here. So true function is a piecewise smooth, so deep networks are optimal, and it is better than the sum of other methods. And we also find the structure of the deep neural networks for the optimality. So, and we provide, this is our take-home message. I mean, question is why deep neural networks perform better. And one reason, just one reason from our theory is that so data are generated from the non-smooth functions. So this is our claim. Thank you for listening.
I would like to ask how you find the m number of pieces.
M is a basis. Sorry, number of the piece or base. You are mentioning about this m. Yes. So in this study, we do not discuss about how to find. Practically, we do not discuss about the finding. So we only we show is that the existence of deep neural networks. So we do not discuss about the finding.
You see, in your proof, you construct the optimal network using the
of course. I mean,
and the indicator function.
Yes. I mean, of course.
You may need to know the number.
Yes, I agree with you. So in our proof, we assume that true m is known, and we construct unknown means that our deep neural networks for proof should include the information of large m. So our proof depends on large m, yes, of course. So we assume that the m is known, and if it is known, so we can assure the existence of optimal deep neural networks.
I'm curious about the number of king
boys.
May go to infinity?
J is a finite, and M is also finite. We assume that.
So it's really great. So thank you very much. Thank you.